This afternoon's highlights will begin at the University of Taipei Diving Pool. 29 men took to the 1-meter springboard to battle it out for the top spot. But the final hosted just the top 8 athletes, including Korea's Kim Young-nang and Wu Haram, who won the bronze medal in yesterday's 10-meter platform synchro event. FISU President Oleg Matitsyn was poolside for today's event, and first up onto the board was Russia's Evgeny Kuznetsov with a 2.5 somersault tuck. Kuznetsov won the silver medal at the 2012 Olympic Games in the men's 3-meter synchro. This wasn't his most difficult dive of the day. He did attempt a difficulty degree of 3.2 with a forward 2.5 somersault 1 twist pike. Beautiful execution, just rotated a little bit too much on the entry. You can see the Russian fans quite happy with that one. And it brings him up to 290.2 for a total of 434.2. Good for the bronze medal. Next up is the USA's Briadam Herrera. He hails originally from Cuba. He now represents the University of Miami and was named back-to-back NCAA All-American. He also won Team USA's first medal, a bronze medal, back in Gwangju in 2015, and he was also the team's flag bearer at the opening ceremony here in Taipei. This dive here would put him in first place for a total of 449.25, but he wasn't quite safe there because next up was Korea's Kim Young-nam. Like I said earlier, he won the bronze in the men's 10-meter synchro platform event just yesterday, and he began diving at age 11, now 21, so 10 years of experience. And the most difficult dive today is the inward 2.5 somersault pike, which he does absolutely beautiful. His entry here, almost no splash whatsoever, and you can see as he bows to the crowd, he knows that that will be good for the gold medal. It brings him to a total of 453. Korea's Kim Young-nam grabs the gold medal. USA's Briadam Herrera is good for the silver, and Russia picks up that number 3 spot. Kim Young-nam has 2 medals now to his name, a bronze medal from yesterday and now a gold medal from today at his first Universiad. Quite the performance. We'll stay at the University of Taipei's diving pool, but move over to the women's synchronized 10-meter platform event. 6 duos qualified for the final, representing Russia, Australia, Japan, Italy, Macau, and the Democratic People's Republic of Korea. First up on the platform are Russia's pair Yulia Tikhomirova and Yulia Timoshinina. The 19-year-old competed at the 2016 Olympics. Now the duo will attempt the forward 3.5 somersault with a difficulty degree of 3.0. A very difficult dive, you can see, just a bit out of sync. Watch one more time. Just not turning their bodies at the same time. But the judges award them 192.03, a score there of 63. It brings them up to 263.07 for a total, and it will be good for the bronze medal. Next up is Australia's Emily Kate Meaney and Brittany O'Brien. O'Brien competed at the 2016 Olympic Games for the women's 10-meter platform event. The duo will attempt the same forward 3.5 somersault dive. Great execution into the water as they stay just about the same in synchronization heading down. Their entry, minimal splash, and the judges award them 68.4 on that dive. It brings their total up to 297.84. Next up is the pair from the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, Kim Kup-yang and Kim Eung-yang. Kim Kup-yang won the silver medal at the 2017 World Aquatics Championship. But before that, at the 2015 World Aquatics Championship, she became the first world champion for Team North Korea after earning the gold medal in the 10-meter platform. Her partner, Kim Eung-yang, no slouch herself, quite the resume, has competed at the 2012 and 2016 Olympic Games. You can see their experience coming to light here as they enter the water with almost perfection. And the judges agree they get 65.7 on that dive, bringing their total to 303.54. Good enough to earn the gold medal in the women's 10-meter platform synchro event. This is the duo's first gold medal competing together in a synchro event on a world stage. The diving event will continue tomorrow with the women's platform qualifiers and semifinals and the men's 3-meter synchro springboard finals. We'll move to a drier venue now for the men's and women's weightlifting. Tamgang University Memorial Gym was home to the women's 53-kilogram and men's 69-kilogram events today. First up is the women's event, where 11 athletes qualified to the final lift.
Number one, Stu Natasha from Slovenia.
First up was Thailand's Suprata Khao Kong. Earlier, she had successfully snatched 86 kilograms, and on her first attempt now, she goes for 105. This first attempt is 5 to 7 kilograms lighter than the first and second women ahead of her. She made this one look easy. In her third attempt, she would successfully get up 111, giving her a total of 197, which placed her in the top three. Next was China's Liu Feng. In her first snatch attempt, she successfully lifted 88, her second 90, but she wasn't able to put it up, so this will be her third attempt at 90 kilograms. Successful for the Chinese athlete, and with her final clean and jerk a few turns later, she was successful lifting 117 kilos for a total of 207. Now, the Democratic People's Republic of Korea's Soo Young Ri. In her first snatch attempt, she lifted 87 kilos quite easily, now attempting 90. Making that one look easy. In her third attempt, she does try 91 but isn't successful, so her snatch will stay at 90. And for her clean and jerks, she lifted a total of 118, giving her an overall total of 208. Good enough for that number one position. Soo Young Ri of North Korea wins the gold medal for her country, and the silver medal goes to Feng Liu of China, and the bronze medal for Thailand is Suprata Khao Kong. The men's 69-kilogram event took place next. 10 athletes qualified for the final, including the Democratic People's Republic of Korea's Myung-hyun Kim, who we will see first. He set a new Universiad record in the snatch earlier with the 150 kilograms, and he would attempt another Universiad record now with a clean and jerk, lifting 178 kilograms in his second attempt. And with that, the North Korean athlete sets a new Universiad record in both the snatch and the clean and jerk. But Japan's Masanori Miyamoto would use his third attempt in the clean and jerk to re-break that record. He put 179 kilograms on the bar. And the excitement on his face says it all as he breaks another Universiad record. But his overall score will still place him behind North Korea's Kim due to his low snatch score. Next to the platform is Kazakhstan's Albert Linden. Now his first attempt here will again break the Universiad record because, of course, that's the story of today's event. He will attempt to lift 180 if he does so. He will re-break that Universiad record. With his coaches cheering him on, he puts it above his head and it's good. The record is broken once again. And to continue on in his second attempt, he successfully lifted 185 in the clean and jerk, and that will be the new Universiad record. With his combination total, with his snatch of 148, clean and jerk of 185, he takes the gold with a total of 333. Kazakhstan takes the gold in the 69-kilogram men's weightlifting final with Albert Linder, a total of 333. North Korea's Kim finished with a total of 331 after a high snatch, setting that Universiad record at 153. And Japan came in bronze after a 145 snatch and a 179 clean and jerk for a total of 324.
Time trial for men.
We will head outside now to enjoy the sun and hot weather at the Yingfen River Park Roller Rink. The men's 3,000-meter time trial qualifying round was earlier today, and the top 18 made it to the finals. Leading the pack after the qualifiers was Republic of Korea's Jin Young Kim with a time of 24.32. His teammate Korea's Seong-young Hong placed sixth in the qualifying round, but would outperform his earlier race to earn a medal in the finals of this event. As he crosses the finish line, he will end with a time of 24.452, a much better race than his earlier race in the qualifiers where he was 24.965, puts him in the top spot. But next up is Taipei's Pao Mo Chi. He finished fourth in the qualifying round with a time of 24.757. Thank you.
the result for 31-006, Hamid Lemon from Colombia is 24.966.
As he approaches the finish line, he knows it could be good enough for a medal. He pushes it, and he gets a time of 24.371. That puts him now in that number one spot. But now it's the UTEP University student who led the qualifiers with a time of 24.32. He sets up now at the start line. No one in the final race has been faster than his qualifying race, but the question is, of course, can he do it again? A good start here for the Korean athlete, giving it his all in this final bout. Now taking a step back, the world record for this men's 300-meter time trial race was set in 2015 by Colombia's Andreas Jimenez with a time of 23.415. As he's approaching the finish line, 21 on the clock, he pushes it. And with a final time of 23.949, he beat his qualifying round. He is the fastest in the qualifiers, the fastest in the finals. And you can see how happy everyone is. They know that he has won the gold medal in the men's 300-meter time trial. Athletes from the Republic of Korea absolutely cleaning up in this event. Of course, Jin Young Kim pulling out that gold medal race, and his teammate, Seong Ying Hong, won the bronze earlier with the women's 1,000-meter points elimination race. It was also Korea's Garam Yoo who won the bronze. Roller sports will continue tomorrow with men's and women's 1,000-meter sprint and men's and women's 1,500-meter elimination races. Judo continued today at the Hsinchu County Gymnasium with the women's under 63 and under 70 kilogram events and the men's under 81 and under 90 kilogram events. First on the mat in the under 63 kilogram category is Japan's Amy Nucci and Algeria's Amina Belkadi. With about a minute and 46 on the clock, Belkadi gets a Shido, and then at the 220 mark, it's Nucci who scores a quick Waza air. You can see it coming up here now. This pin wouldn't be enough for an Epon, but give her 22 seconds and she will get it. She wins by Epon at the 2 minute and 42 mark. This is both athletes' first Universiade, and 21-year-old Amy Nucci of Japan picks up her first medal, and it's a gold. Next on the mat in the men's under 81 kilogram event is Korea's Seonggu Lee and Russia's Aslan Lapinagov. Go. 27-year-old Seongsun Lee from Korea won a silver medal at the 2013 Universiade in Kazan for the team event and going for his second medal here today. Seongsu Lee scored a quick Waza Airy there. You can see he's up by one. Looks to kind of just avoid Russia's Aslan Lapinagov the rest of the match. Now, although there's a couple Shidos penalized to both players both ways, the time runs out, and it's Seongsu Lee who comes up on top, 1-0. He wins the gold medal in the men's under 81 kilogram category. Here's the early Waza Airy scored by Korea's Seongsu Lee, the only successful throw in the entire bout. Next up is the women's under 70 kilogram gold medal match between Japan's Saki Nizo in the white, and Brazil's Barbara Chiengotimo in the blue. Throughout the 4 minutes of regular time, both athletes got some shidos to their name, but no one able to put a point on the board. 30 seconds now left to go. You can see time is running out. Now moving on to golden score. This is somewhat like sudden death. First athlete to score a point will take the gold medal. Both athletes going at it hard, but defending themselves quite well. 3 minutes, 18 seconds on the clock. Now remember, there's no time limit here. First person to score wins. They would still go for over another minute. You can tell both of them just completely exhausted after this matchup. Happy coach in the background with 4 minutes and 30 seconds into the golden score. It's Brazil's Barbara Chiengotimo who comes out on top with a Waza Airy to take the gold medal. Rewatching Chiengotimo's golden point, she takes advantage of the right leg slip by Nizo and slams both of Nizo's shoulders to the ground. A well-deserved gold medal after a long and hard-fought match. Next up is the two-time defending Universiad gold medalist, Korea's Donghan Gwak, taking on Russia's Stanislav Radinsky. Gwak won the gold medal at the 2013 and the 2015 Summer Universiad and most recently won a bronze medal at the 2016 Olympic Games. Just about a minute into this bout, referee blows his whistle, dishes out a few shidos, one to each athlete, and they continue on their way. Neither one able to score a point yet. 2 minutes, 33 seconds, and just as I say it, Korea's Donghan Gwak throws Radinsky over his shoulder. It won't be good enough for an Ippon, but he is awarded 1 point for a Waza Airy. As the time runs out, the score is 1-0 for Korea's Donghan Gwak. After a powerful Waza Airy late in the matchup, he earns the victory and is now a three-time gold medalist for the men's under 90 kilogram judo event here at the 2017 FISU Summer Universiad. Taekwondo's Team Pumsei events finished up today at the Taoyuan Arena. The women's team event featured 8 teams, and with the home team of Taipei competing first, the crowd was going wild. Taipei's Chen Yaoxian, Li Yingxian, and Chen Xiaoting, who ended third in the qualifying round, took to the mat. Second pattern here scored a 7.58 and combined with the 8.1 from their first pattern, Taipei ended with a total of 75. Next was the Republic of Korea's Yao Guan, Ju Yun, and So Yung Park. This group ended in the top spot heading into the finals. Their first pattern scored them an 8.16, just a sliver ahead of Team Taipei. It was their 3.3 accuracy score that gave them the leg up heading into this second pattern. This pattern for the Republic of Korea scores a 7.83, earning them a total of 77.3. Team Korea wins the gold medal, Taipei the silver, and Vietnam wins the bronze. Next, we will see the top performance of the men's Team Poonsae event, featuring the Republic of Korea, who earned the gold medal in both the men's and women's team events. Their first pattern earned them a score of 8.16, building them a substantial lead over second place Team Taipei going into the second pattern. It was their near-perfect presentation scores that put them ahead after the first pattern, and nothing changed after this one. Korea scores a 3 in presentation and a 7.4 for overall performance for that second pattern. They end with a total of 77.8, almost a full 3 points more than the second place finisher. The Republic of Korea wins the gold medal with a total of 77.8. Chinese Taipei win the silver medal for this event with 74.9. Vietnam and Iran share that third place spot on the podium. As for the women's Team Poonsae, it was the Republic of Korea that won the gold as well, sweeping this event. They finished with a score of 77.3. Behind them was the Chinese Taipei, also picking up the silver for the women. They finished with a score of 75. And Vietnam and China won the bronze for this event. The individual Taekwondo matches will begin tomorrow. The victory ceremony for women.